हेलो गाइस, आई एम विजिबल? प्लीज कंफर्म मी वंस। हेलो गाइस, आई कांट एबल टू सी एनी मेंबर ओवर हियर, बट द लाइक्स आर देयर एंड कमेंट्स आर कमिंग। कांट सी एनीथिंग। ओके ओके, हाँ डन डन डन। ओके, गॉट इट गॉट इट। हेलो प्रेरणा एंड मीनू, हेलो संगमित्रा, कृति गुप्ता। चलो नाउ इट इज ओके, आई थिंक आई फील। लेट अस स्टार्ट गाइस। एवरी डे यूजीसी नेट पेपर वन, पीपल एंड एनवायरमेंट प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग फ्रॉम 2004 वी हैव स्टार्टेड गाइस। नाउ वी आर ऑलमोस्ट रीच टू 2019 ईयर, फ्रॉम 2004 टू 2019 ईयर। टुडे एट 5 PM जून 2019 प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एट अनअकैडमी फ्री प्लेटफॉर्म गाइस। द लिंक इज गिवन बिलो, प्लीज गो थ्रू विद द लिंक एंड क्लिक ऑन माय प्रोफाइल सेक्शन दैट इज वडनाला शिवलिंगम। द लिंक इज गिवन बिलो, इफ यू क्लिक ऑन दैट वन, आफ्टर दैट यू कैन सी फॉलो बटन, क्लिक ऑन फॉलो बटन एंड गो टू द स्पेशल क्लासेस इन माय प्रोफाइल सेक्शन। आफ्टर दैट क्लिक ऑन नोटिफाई मी फॉर अपकमिंग लाइव सेशन। There it is scheduled. Today's session and tomorrow's session, day after tomorrow's session, upcoming all live sessions are scheduled there. You can just click on and to enroll it. So here daily at 5 PM this session will be there guys. We'll be meeting at 5 PM. Today at this time 12 PM we are taking commerce. And tomorrow also guys, sorry, today at 3 PM also we are having a June 2019 commerce question paper part number 3 is going to be there. So two commerce sessions today. And you can use my invite code Shiva Live to unlock the free live session. And if you want to join in an Academy Plus platform, you can use my referral code Shiva Vodnala to get 10% off. Whether it is a normal plus subscription or an Academy iconic subscription. So iconic subscription will be having a personal coach and personal everything will be a personalized coaching and personal mentoring and personal total supervision will be there by one person who is allocated to the entire thing. So he will be clearing out all your doubts and various things are available. And here Shiva Vodnala is my referral code guys, whether it is normal plus subscription or iconic. One subscription which will give access to all the educator live session and all the educator PDF study material you can able to access. So Shiva Vodnala is my referral code over here to get 10% additional discount and your credits will be another additional 10% discount. Day after tomorrow guys, that is 28th February Sunday 4 PM to 5 PM we are going to have an Academy Accelerate, which is a scholarship 100% scholarship test for the NTA UGCNET Academy subscription. So try to attend this test and link is given below, please go through with the link. Do join in my Telegram group and follow me in Academy Learning app. So ready for the session, business environment and international business questions PYQ. Let us start. Hello, Commerce. Apex Consumer Court in India is referred as in the Consumer Education and Research Center, the Consumer Unity and Trust of Society, National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, none of the above. Option C is a given answer, guys. That is, National Commission has been set up under the provision of the Section 9 of the Consumer Protection Act. The place of the National Commission is at New Delhi. This is resolving the National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission enters the complaint with the highest value in terms of money. So whenever value is high, you can place a complaint in this National Commission, guys, which is we will be having an appellate tribunal, guys. Actually present national consumer appellate tribunal is there, National Consumer Appellate Tribunal, which is also titled as a National Commission for Redressal Commission. Actually, National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission is at national level, whereas in the state level we'll be having State Level Consumer Redressal Commission and District Level Consumer Redressal Commission. These three things will be there generally. So here if you can look at the new provision, if you are having a value up to 20 lakh, you need to approach the district commission previously. But the limit has been enhanced now. If you are having a value of the complaint up to 1 crore, approach the district commission. 1 crore to 10 crore value of a complaint, approach the state commission. And above 10 crore, approach the national commission. Like these three limits have been new limits which is given. This is the crux of the new Consumer Protection Act. Next, which of the following is not included in the consumer rights as per the Consumer Protection Act 1986? So guys, here option number C is a given answer, that is right to physical environment that will protect and enhances the quality of life. This right is not available under the Consumer Protection Act, but we are having a right of consumer that will be protected against the marketing of the goods which is hazardous in nature, and protection against the right quantity, right quality and the potency and purity of the product, and right to be assured wherever possible for a variety of goods and services, and right to be heard and to be assured at a consumer interest, and right to seek redressal against the unfair trade practices or restrictive trade practices, and right to consumer education. These are the various rights that we are having over here. Next, Industrial Development Regulation Act, IDREA. Import and Export Control Act, Foreign Exchange Management Act, Factories Act. Industrial Development Regulation Act. Try to match it. Option C is a given answer, guys. That is Industrial Development Regulation Act is in 1951 and Import and Export Act is in 47. Option C is given, right? Initially Import and Export Act 1947. Later, Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999 and Factories Act 1948. Let me tell you about Import and Export Act, guys. So here, 1951, there is no doubt in it. Industrial Development Regulation Act was formulated for the purpose of regulating the industries in central by the central government. So here, in the year 1947, it has to replace the provision of permanent enactment, how this the specific act has been enacted for the Import and Export Control Act 1947 came into effect in 1947, 25th March. In case of amount claimed by consumer is 89 lakhs, then which of the following handles this case? As per the old act, you need to answer, but I will tell you the new act. Yes, B is correct. 1947 is correct. Up to 89 lakhs. So option B is a given answer at that time, guys. But as of now, it should come under the district consumer as per the new. As per the new, option A should be the answer. As per the old, option B. So already we discussed, up to 1 crore value, the dispute complaint has to go to the district commission only. And state commission complaint value will be from 1 crore to 10 crore, it will be there. National commission over and above the 10 crore will be there. Right, balance of payment includes current account, capital account, unilateral payment account and official settlement account, revenue account, profit and loss account, capital account and official account, trade account, activity account, revenue account, currency account and forex account, trade account, fund account. The balance of payment will be included. Option number A is a given answer, guys. Exactly, option number A is the correct answer. So here, components of balance of payment will include trade in goods. First, current account will be there, capital account will be there, official reserve account will be there. In the current account, trade in goods, trade in services, transfer payment will be there. And in the capital account, we'll be having an investment, external borrowings, external assistance will be there. In the investment, direct investment, portfolio investment, both will be covered in the capital account. So not only this, guys, there is a separate account called as an official reserve account will be there, which is part of the balance of payment account. Next, the balance of payment presenting, the balance of payment presents a classified record of all the receipts on account of goods exported and service rendered, capital received by the resident and payment made by them to on account of goods imported and services received from the capital transferred to non-resident or foreigners. Reason is given, balance of payment of a country is a systematic record of all the economic transactions between the residents of a country and rest of the world. Option A, let us see. Option A is a given answer, guys. First, whatever the big statement which is given is perfectly opting for the balance of payment definition. It is a record of all the receipts on account of export and payment on account of imports. That we are doing is coming under the balance of payment, which is like a balance sheet for the our receipt and payment account for the entire country is called as a balance of payment account. So next, that is exactly a definition of the balance of payment only. Next, identify the items which does not coming under the current account transaction. Identify the item which does not coming under the current account transaction in the balance of payment. The services, non-monetary movement of the gold, unilateral transfer, investment income. Which one will not be formed part of the current account? ऑप्शन बी इज अ गिवन आंसर गाइस, दैट इज नॉन मॉनिटरी मूवमेंट ऑफ गोल्ड विल नॉट बी कमिंग अंडर द नॉन मॉनिटरी मूवमेंट ऑफ गोल्ड विल नॉट बी कमिंग अंडर द करंट अकाउंट ट्रांजैक्शन बिकॉज गोल्ड इज एन कैपिटल लाइक इन्वेस्टमेंट टाइप इट इज कमिंग अंडर द इन्वेस्टमेंट्स ऑफ ए करंट अकाउंट सॉरी कैपिटल अकाउंट नॉट अंडर द लाइक करंट अकाउंट वी कैन से तो करंट अकाउंट विल बी हैविंग ए ट्रेडिंग गुड्स ट्रेडिंग सर्विसेज ट्रांसफर ऑफ पेमेंट्स ओनली so whereas other than these three which will be coming under the capital account are they are asking current account transaction next vishesh krishi upaj yojana and epcg and dfrc depb the respective schemes and their components are a meaning of that scheme purpose of the scheme is given on other side try to answer option number d let us see actually you need to know the meaning of that each and every scheme na vishesh krishi upaj yojana it is an introduced for exporting the fruits vegetables flowers this minor forest produce whatever is there that has to be improvised for that only a subsidy type of scheme introduced by the government of india is called as an vishesh krishi upaj yojana That is the export of these products will be increasing where export duty will not be levied up to 5% on these goods to improvisation of that particular industry. Next duty entitlement passbook DEPB is basically it is introduced to neutralize the incidence of basis of custom duty on the import content of the exported products like This is consisting of post-export DEPB, pre-export DEP. Both will be there under the duty entitlement passbook. Next, duty-free replenishment certificate. These are import incentives are received by importer for the import of goods used in the manufacture of goods without any payment of a custom duty. There is no need to pay any custom duty for importing any type of manufactured. If you want to import the raw material. No need to pay any import duty as per this duty free replenishment certificate because in order to manufacture these type of goods which are not much available in India. Next EPCG is an export promotion capital goods scheme. Export promotion capital goods is coming under the EPCG. Next guys, the member countries consistently finding balance of payment crisis. May approach the World Bank for seeking financial accommodation to mitigate or to decrease the crisis. And the member nation facing a balance of payment crisis can approach the IMF seeking a redressal of BOP crisis. Member nations. Answer, please. Option C is a given answer, guys. That is, R is correct and A is wrong. Whenever balance of payment problem arises, we should approach the right bank to get the funding. That is, IMF is a person or the body which will give the country's breathing room for implement and adjust the policies and reform. Reform that will restore the condition for strong and sustainable growth. So here the policies which will be vary depending upon the country's circumstances, including the cause of the problem, that is payment, balance of payment problem generally. So generally guys, member country can receive a loan and a country authorities and the IMF may agree on a program of economic policies when you are integral part of the IMF. So we should approach the IMF when we are having a balance of payment. It is, we should not approach the World Bank for the balance of payment problem in order to adjust those problems. Next, in computation of the balance of payment, overall balance of payment is equal to balance of current account plus balance of capital account plus statistical discrepancy. Export of goods and invisibles minus import of goods, foreign exchange inflow minus outflow, and export of goods and invisibles plus import of goods and invisibles. Which one will be the answer? Option A, which is covering a broader sense. So option A is a given answer, guys. Correct. Current account, balance of payment shows current account, capital account, all the things, official reserve, which is a statistical discrepancy. In all the cases, inflow minus outflow, that is exports minus imports, will be the final one, which is current account balance, capital account balance, and statistical discrepancy balance. Three things will be added together. Next, poverty reduction growth facility, PRGF scheme, which is, these are the schemes of IMF which is introduced in respective years. Poverty reduction growth facility and supplemental reserve facility, extended fund facility, 1997, 1974, 1999. Option A is a given answer, guys. PRGF. PRGF is a scheme which is introduced in the year 1999, which is mainly provided, a funding provided by the IMF is to lower income countries. We will be providing a funding from the IMF, which is enhanced structural adjustment facility. In the year 1999, a decision was made to strengthen the focus on poverty. So that is why this scheme has been introduced by the government of India. Next, standby agreement is been introduced in, like, standby agreement is nothing but one of the agreement or one of the scheme of the IMF only. And extended fund facilities in 1974 to help the countries to address more protracted balance of payment problem to root the structure of economy. And supplement reserve facility in the year 1997, to meet the need for very short-term financing, we have launched this SRF under the IMF scheme. SDRs are popularly known as currency note, paper gold, silver coin, gold coin. SDRs are popularly known as. Option B is a given answer, that is paper gold. So these are very special drawing rights, SDRs are denominations of the quotas in the IMF, guys, International Monetary Fund, paper gold. So these are denominated in a special drawing rights. These are having a value of 5 currency brackets, 5 basket of currencies will be there in this, because IMF is having so many, 180 plus countries are there, every country is having their own currency. In order to bring them a uniformity form, all the currencies have been divided into a 5 top currencies only. They have taken up based on their share. So here highest dollar, highest share is by US 41.73%, Euro 30%, Renminbi Chinese Yuan, and third Japanese Yen, fourth, and British Pound is having a fifth. So these are the respective percentages, and whatever the respective share will be having. Like if the share of this particular countries are more, means that will be having the basket in 5 top currencies. Only 5 top currencies will be chosen. This is treated as an paper gold, which is not an international institution. Which is not an international institution. IMF, IDA, IBRD, TROY. So option D is not an international institution, that is TROY. TROY is not at all an international institution, guys. Percentage is most important. International Development Association, International Bank for Reconstruction, and International Monetary Fund, all are coming under the international institutions only, except a Telephone Regulatory Authority of India, which is an Indian Regulatory Authority for the Telecommunication Industry, 1997 year. Which one is called as in Bretton Woods Twins? IBRD IDA, IMF IFC, IMF IBRD, and IDA IFC. Option, look at option C is a given answer. C is a given answer. Guys, IMF and IBRD is a correct answer. IMF and IBRD. What is IBRD, guys? IBRD is the original name of the World Bank. Original name of the World Bank. Initial name. World Bank is an international financial institution which provides loans for the development of the countries in the world of capital projects. It is comprising of two things. Actually, it is World Bank is not only initially comprising of two things, that is International Bank for the Reconstruction and Development, IBRD, and International Development Association. These both are there under the World Bank. But now it is an association of the five group of institution. Not only this IBRD, IDA, which is also IFC is there, International Financial Corporation, and this one MICGI is there, and the last one is that dispute settlement is also there. Total five institution which are coming under here. And whereas, look at the IMF is an International Monetary Fund. This both World Bank and International Monetary Fund at a time they formed in the year 1944. International Monetary Fund was set up in the 1944 to promote the international monetary cooperation through permanent institution. Hello, Chanchal. Option B is a correct answer, guys. In the year July 1944 only, in the year 1944 July, the Bretton Woods Conference twins has been established, that is International Monetary Fund and World Bank got established. But IMF technically started its operation in the year 1945, 27th December, where it started its operation on 1945, 27th December, guys, mainly for promoting a international monetary cooperation and exchange rate stability, balanced international trade, economic assistance to member countries with a BOP problem, and minimum imbalance in the duration of a trade. Next, which is not an objective of the IMF? Which is not an objective of the IMF? Which is not an objective of the IMF? To promote international monetary cooperation, to ensure the balanced international trade, to finance the productive efforts according to the peacetime requirement, to ensure the exchange rate stability. Option C is a given answer. To finance the productive efforts according to the peacetime requirement is not an objective of the IMF. Whereas remaining objective, if you look at, it is promoting the monetary cooperation at an international level. Exchange stability is the main one. And economic assistance to member countries with a balance of payment problem. Minimum imbalance in the duration of the trade. And balance of international trade. To create the standby reserves, which will provide the funding for the increase of the trade and establish a multilateral system of a payment. Next, guys, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development was set up in 1944, 1954, 1960, 1964. United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, which is not an, they are asking not an objective of the IMF. Peacetime requirement, these are not there under the IMF. They are asking which is not an objective. Please look at the question carefully. International trade is also promoted by the IMF. remove the restriction, World Trade Organization is there. Union Nation Conference on Trade and Development. So answer is D, guys. United Nation Conference on Trade and Development is established in the year 1964, which is a permanent intergovernmental body. So headquartered at Geneva in Switzerland, guys. Here we are having a five list. Sorry, four lists are there, which is under the UNCTAD. In the year 1964, it got established. List number one will be having a African and Asia Pacific groups of United Nations. List B is having a Western European countries. List C will be having a Latin American and Caribbean states. And list D is having a Eastern European group of countries. Our country, India, is there in the list A of the UNCTAD list, which is mainly the goal of this organization is to maximize the trade and maximize the investment, development opportunities for every country, and assisting them to integrate with other total world economy and improve their economy. Next. Which of the following is not an agency of the World Bank? MIGA, ICSID, ADB, IDA. Option C is the given answer, guys. Because World Bank Group is having two set of goals by the 2030. That goals are different. But there are five institutions which we are having. Under the World Bank, we are having a five institutions or five bodies are there. Which is body number one, 1944, International Bank for the Reconstruction and Development. Which is giving a lending to the intergovernment who are having a middle growth countries will be there now, who are having a low income countries. That will be having, IBRD will be funding to them. Second, International Development Association will be funding to the interest-free loans to very poorest countries in the world, total. International Development Association, IDA. And International Finance Corporation will be giving loans to the private sector, 1956. Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency, which was established in the year 1988, providing foreign direct investment into a development of the growth of various countries. And International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes, which is founded in the year 1966, mainly to settle down any type of disputes at an international level, which is at a World Bank major transactions will be there now, country to country, international business transaction dispute settlement will be done as per the ICSID. Next, which is not a component of an international reserve? Special drawing rights, reserve position in the IMF, monetary gold, monetary market. So option D is a given answer, guys. Let me tell you the components which is coming under the definition of an international reserve. These not coming under, that is money market instrument is not coming under the international reserve. But the definition is crucial one for international business questions, guys. Because this is a question which is repeated many times. Definition of international liquidity or a reserve. International liquidity or a reserve will be having gold held by the central bank, like our RBI, gold there with the RBI, and foreign currencies held by the RBI. Various, for India, RBI is a central bank. Like that, every country will be having a central bank. Gold held by all the central bank across the world. Foreign currencies held by the all the central banks across the world. And borrowing facilities available from the IMF under the different schemes. Special drawing rights, which is a basket of currency of IMF. Credit facilities available under the swap agreements. And a country borrowing capacity in the international market. These all are coming under the components or parts of the international reserve definition or international liquidity definition. Next, Bretton Woods Conference, soft loan window, Geneva, loan to private sector. Identify and match it. Option C is the given answer, guys. Look at why C is the given answer. That is this one. C2, Bretton Woods Conference to World Bank, correct? And soft loan window, International Development Association, and Geneva, which is a headquarter of World Trade Organization, and loan to private sector is by International Finance Corporation. That is option number C. Just now we have discussed in the last question. A soft loan is nothing but where interest rate in the market is not going to be applicable for the soft loan windows. In the soft loan, we will be having a less rate of interest as compared to the market. That is why it is called as a soft loan window. Next, which one of the following is not an advantage of the MNC to host country? To the host country, which of the following is not an advantage of the multinational companies? Increase in social activity. Increase in economic activity. Utilization of the natural resources, R&D efforts enhanced. Which one of the following is not an advantage of the MNC from the host country point of view? Option A is a correct answer, guys, because increase in social activity of which country? Of which country? Look at advantage for the multinational corporation on the host country may be enumerated. So research and development activities, guys, developing the countries lack in research and development areas with multinational companies when the technology is going to be adopted from the various other countries. And far-reaching effects on the economic and political conditions will be there. Much impact will be there on the economic and political conditions of the host country will be there. Because our country companies are going into the other countries. For them, they are going to have a big benefit from out of various other companies. So, which will be increasing their economic growth of that particular country. Increase in profits of that particular country. Developing a new product in that country. Reducing operational cost. And reducing labor cost. These are the possible advantages for the host country from the point of view of the multinational company growth. Wider market, turnkey project, expanding the production capacities, geocentric approach, modes of entry, goal of international business, advantages of international business, and stages of globalization. Thank you. option B is a correct answer, guys. That is, look at option B is a correct answer. Advantage of the international business is wider market, where our scope is much more. Modes of entries, one of the mode of entry into the international business is the turnkey project. And goal of international business is that expanding the production capacities. Mainly our production capacity from the domestic to national, international level. And stages of globalization is a geocentric approach. Stages of globalization, geocentric approach will be there over here. And an MNC that maintains a balance between the home country and host country market oriented policies is called as a balance between the both market is called as an ethnocentric firm, polycentric, geocentric, none of the above. Very sorry for that. I think sometimes singing is very annoying, correct? Na? With this type of voice. Option C is the correct answer, guys. An MNC that maintains a balance between the home market and host market. Look at. Home market and host market is a geocentric approach. Look at here, guys. There are four approaches in the EPRG framework, which is ethnocentric, home country market mainly. In the ethnocentric, the company will be, whatever the home country approach is there, same will be followed in that international business host country also. Polycentrism is nothing but host country approach will be followed. Regiocentrism is nothing but according to the region, we are going to maintain the approach of international business. Whereas geocentrism is nothing but host and home country equal importance. At a worldwide, a single approach will be followed by the geocentric. That is why it will be maintaining a balance between the both. Franchising is a practice of. Franchising is a practice of leasing for a prescribed period of time. The right to use the firm's successful business model and the brand, selling out a successful business models and the brand, hiring a firm's successful business model and the brand. Option A is a correct answer. That is, franchising is a practice of leasing for a prescribed period of time, right to use the firm's successful business model and the brand. Look at permitting another party in a foreign country to produce, to sell the goods under your trademark and patents or copyrights in lieu of some fee is another way of entering into an international business. Permitting another party in a foreign country to produce, to sell the goods under your trademarks or patents. Like we are going to take a franchise of Reliance Fresh is nothing but we are going to use the trademark and copyright and patent and the name and everything of a Reliance Fresh. Then we are doing a transactions over here or in the foreign country also. That is what exactly a franchising meaning. McDonald's is the best example for international franchise. From the following modes of international business, identify the mode which involves strategic alliance. What do you mean by strategic alliance? Strategic alliance. Franchising, लीजिंग, टर्न की प्रोजेक्ट, ज्वाइंट वेंचर. ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज अ करेक्ट आंसर. लुक एट डी इज अ करेक्ट आंसर विच इज जॉइंट वेंचर लाइसेंसिंग. देर आर वेरियस थिंग्स गाइस एंड हियर इफ यू लुक एट द टोटल ऑल द मोड्स ऑफ एंटरिंग इनटू इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस इफ यू वांट यू कैन टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट आल्सो. ऑल द थिंग्स आर कवर्ड ओवर हियर. लाइसेंसिंग इज नथिंग बट गिविंग अ परमिशन टू अ पर्सन यूज इट लीगली फॉर अ प्रोटेक्टेड प्रोडक्ट और अ टेक्नोलॉजी. लाइसेंसिंग फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम फॉर अ फी. Franchising is also semi-independent. Like owner will be there, we are using the patent and copyright, everything and name and fame of the owner or the main brand, and we are paying a franchise's fees for them or commission also. And joint R&D is nothing but combine the technical knowledge and do the research. Turnkey project is nothing but if you want to go into international business, there you don't know how the business will work. So you are approaching some turnkey project. Who will make a turnkey project? Like decide everything and design and everything, do and set up everything, give the final key to me. That is what turnkey project. You are entering into international business in that way. Next, mergers and acquisition, we know very well. Ownership and control like amalgamation will be there. Contract to manufacturing, when a firm hires a local manufacturer to produce their product or part of their product is known as contract manufacturing. When a firm, foreign firm is hiring you to make any type of specialized technological or skill oriented product, na, then they will acquire you for that particular purpose only. Joint venture is nothing but sharing of the ownership and management with another company, which is a strategic alliance actually. Greenfield strategy is an expanding of our foreign market operation from the scratch, like a zero based budgeting. From the zero, you are going to hero in the foreign market. And management contracting, it provides technical advice as a managerial assistance only. Only technical services or the assistance will be provided to foreign country. A common market is one where all the trading nations agree commonly to levy a common and uniform tariff rate for all the goods. All the trading nations agree commonly to rationalize the tariff and non-tariff barriers, mutually to promote intra-region trade. There is a custom union along with a free intra-union movement of factors of production. There is an economic union along with a free intra-union movement of a resident. In the regional economic integration, preferential trade agreement, free trade area, common market, custom union and economic union, political union will be there. Out of which common market definition they are asking directly. Option number C is a given answer, guys. In the custom union, with a custom union along with the free movement of factors of production, you can look at the picture over here. Levels of integration where custom union, look at. They are asking common market, na? This one common market they are asking, which include custom union, free trade area plus common trade policies, as well as free movement of factors of production also will be coming under this common market. Am I clear? Next, last question of the day. Trade creation, trade diversion, trade deflection, polarization forces. Questions are, see, if you understand the business environment, international business, scoring area, guys. Very interesting concepts will be there, which are realistic one. Guys, at 3 p.m. again, our YouTube live is going to be there on June 2019 Commerce Question Paper Part Number 3. Option C, Sangamitra is saying. Let us see, guys. Option C is a correct answer. That is, trade creation is a third one, where shifting of locus of production from high cost to low cost center within the union is called. And you are trying to create a trade, that is buying and selling transaction you are trying to create at a low cost is called as a trade creation. Trade diversion is an first one. That is movement of production and resources in an opposite direction. You are diverting the buying and selling transaction to other place. That is what diversion. Trade deflection is an fourth one, guys, where goods produced in third country entered a free trade area through a member country having a lower tariff. Like, trade deflection is nothing but, suppose India and USA is having a trade agreement actually, which is a free trade area agreement between. In between, international flow of a transaction can happen without any duties and charges. But Australia is a friend of USA. Australia is taking advantage. If at all it wanted to import any type of goods from India, na, it is approaching USA. Mr. USA people try to import from India, because you people are having an agreement. Na, then import from India, then send it to me so that I will pay same price for you, because these people will not be having any duties. That situation is called as a trade deflection. Trade deflection. Last one, which is a polarization force, is a second one. Become active. A member country does not augment the exports, but simply shift its imports from low cost to high cost source. Low cost to high cost source. That is what polarization forces. So this is the today's session, guys, which is again we will be having in the same YouTube channel. We will be having a next 3 p.m. session, which is on June 2019 Commerce Solved question papers are going to be there. 25 to 30 questions of Commerce PYQ we are going to discuss of June 2019. At 3 p.m. do not forget. This is at 3 p.m. do not forget. I will be sending a link in my Telegram group and click on a reminder so that you will get the notification whenever I am going live. And do not forget to enroll to today free live session, which is going to happen at 5 p.m. People and Environment previous year questions of 2019 is going to be there, guys. Very interesting session today. More learning point will be there in today's session. The link is given below. Go through with the link and or type it as Udnala Shivlingam in Academy platform so that you will get my profile. Click on the follow button and go to the special classes. And after going to the special classes, you can see all the upcoming scheduled live session. Click on each of the live session and click on notify me for upcoming live session. Thank you so much. Bye to all. Have a nice day. Please do hit the like button if you like the session. And do not forget to subscribe to this channel. And whenever you have wanted to take subscription or you wanted to watch the free live classes, do not forget to use my code SHIVALIVE to unlock free live session and to get 10% off on the Unacademy Plus subscription. Do enroll to free live session by going through with the description. Thank you so much. Bye to all. Have a nice day. We'll be meeting again at 3 p.m.